We all are acquainted with sale where the property is transferred from one person to the another person in exchange of money as a consideration. But in lease, only the right of enjoyment is transferred from one party to the another party and for a specific period of time. Lease is a very important topic of Transfer of Property Act 1882. We all are acquainted with the fact of sale where the property is transferred from one party to the another party. But in lease, this is the right of enjoyment. Only the right of enjoyment is transferred from one party to the another party. So, according to Section 105 of the Transfer of Property Act, lease is a transfer of right of enjoyment, only the right of enjoyment of an immobile property made for a certain period of time, in consideration of price, paid or promised to be paid, or money, or share of props or service given periodically or on specific occasions to the transferor by the transferee. What are the essentials of lease? In lease, there are two parties. One is a transferor and the other is a transferee. Here, only the right of enjoyment is transferred. Lease is granted only for a certain period of time and there is a consideration. These are all the essentials of lease. Now, who is the lessor and who is the lessee? The transferor who is competent to contract, having the authority to grant lease, is called the lessor. And the transferee who is also competent to contract is called the lessee. What is premium? In lease, if the whole amount of price is recovered as consideration is paid by the lessee to the lessor in lump sum, it is called premium. And if the consideration amount such as money or share or service or other things to be rendered is paid periodically, it is not in lump sum, it is paid periodically, then it is called rent. What is the difference between the lease and license? If you know the difference between lease and license, then your concept of lease will be clear. In lease, there is a transfer of right of enjoyment in an immobile property. But in license, no transfer of interest as well as transfer of property. Lease is a limited estate, which is only the right of enjoyment of property, which is called demise. But license is a personal right. Personal right of license using the land of another person. In lease, as a proprietary right, it is a transferable interest. The lessee can transfer his proprietary right, which is called the sublease. But in license, it is a personal right and it cannot be transferable. If you get the driving license, you have no right to transfer this driving license to your friend. So it is a personal right and it cannot be transferred. Lessee can take action against the trespasser. But licensee cannot take action against the trespasser. Lease cannot be revoked before the expiry of the term and without breach of condition. But license is generally revocable. Now, duration of lease in absence of written contract or local usage. According to Section 106, in absence of written contract of local law,
a lease of immobile property for agricultural and manufacturing purpose. What is the purpose? Agricultural or manufacturing purpose. Shall be deemed to be a lease from year to year and terminable by 6 months notice, either by the lessor or the lessee. 6 months notice can be given either by the lessor or by the lessee. And lease of immovable property for any other purpose, that is, which is not the agricultural or manufacturing purpose, for any other purpose, shall be deemed to be a lease from month to month and terminable by 15 days notice. Now, what are the modes of creation of lease? According to section 107, there are two modes of creation of lease. In first mode, where registration is compulsory, and the second mode, registration is optional. Where the registration is compulsory? When the lease is from year to year and lease for a term exceeding 1 year, or lease reserving any yearly rent or permanent lease. In all situations, registration is compulsory. And in the case of lease from month to month, or lease for 1 year, or lease for less than 1 year, registration is optional. In section 108, there are the rights and liabilities of the lessor and the lessee. But this section does not provide any specific rights of the lessor. The liabilities of the lessee as given in this section would mean identical rights of the lessor, because the rights and liabilities are correlatives. So, the liabilities of the lessor. The first liability of the lessor is the duty to disclose the latent material defect. What are the latent material defects? The defects of the property which are not visible. This defect is known to the lessor. This fact must be disclosed by the lessor to the lessee. And duty to give possession to the lessee at his request. This is the right of enjoyment, you know. So, it is his duty, it is the duty of the lessor to give the possession to the lessee so that he can enjoy the property. And the next one is duty for a covenant for quiet enjoyment of the property by lessee. What is the covenant for quiet enjoyment so that no one, any third party cannot interfere his possession? He must have the peaceful possession. What are the rights of the lessee? First one is right to enjoy the accretion to the leased property. What is accretion? Accretion means addition made to the leased property either by human being or by natural force. Next one, rights to avoid lease on destruction of property by fire, flood, or by any other irresistible force. Right to deduct the cost of repairs. If there is any damage of the leased property and it is repaired by the lessee in his own cost, he can demand that amount of money from the lessor. And this amount of money will be deducted from the cost of the leased property. And right to deduct the outgoings, such as the municipal taxes and any other public charges, the revenues, etc. If these outgoings are given by the lessee, he has a right to demand to claim that amount of money from the lessor. Right to remove the fixtures. If there is any fixtures, that is any structure, any building, any tree which are attached to the earth, it is the right of the lessee to remove the fixture after the expiry of the lease period. Right to remove crops, but if the crops are shown by the lessee, then he has the right to remove the crops. Right to assign his interest. Assign means right to use the land, such as he can sublease the property, he can mortgage the property. It is the duty, it is the liability, it is the right of the lessee. These all rights can be enjoyed by the lessee. If the lessee can enjoy the rights, he must bear the liabilities of the, what are the liabilities of the lessee? First one is duty to disclose the fact regarding the increase of the value of the property. Next one, duty to pay rent. If the lease is granted by the lessor to the lessee, it is the duty of the lessee to pay the rent. And it is very important liability of the lessee to maintain the leased property. He must maintain the property so that the property cannot be damaged or destroyed. And duty to give notice of encroachment. If there is any encroachment, if the leased property is encroached by any third party, then it is the duty of the lessee to give notice, to inform the lessor that so that your property is encroached by any third party who is X, Y or Z. It is his duty to give notice of encroachment to the duty to use the property reasonably. Reasonably means so that the property cannot be damaged or destroyed. Duty not to erect any permanent structure, because lease, you know that lease is a only the transfer of the right of enjoyment. Not the whole right is transferred. Only the right of enjoyment is transferred. So, it is the duty of the lessee not to erect any permanent structure, because after the expiry of the period, he must restore the property. He must vacate the property, which is the next duty of the lessee. Duty to restore the possession. To vacate the possession and to restore the property. Next, we will discuss about another important and interesting topic of Transfer of Property Act. Today, ending here. Thank you.